As well as the number of elements that are involved, you have to factor in selector matching. Selector matching is the process of figuring out whether some styles should actually apply to any given DOM element. It's possible to select this div either with its class like this, or with a more complex selector like this. It's complex because in order to know if the style applies, it has to figure out if this is the third child. Whereas with this, it can simply use the class name. Now you may be thinking that this shouldn't matter. And actually for matching a single element, it really doesn't. And this is a pretty simple example. It's only going to take a browser a fraction of a millisecond to figure out the match in both cases. But if you have a large number of elements affected by a style change, then the complexity of the selectors can really start to matter. One approach that works very well is BEM, or Block Element Modifier. And it's a way of writing your CSS. It uses single class names to style elements, and not only does it provide more modular, reusable, and readable styles, it is advantageous to performance, since class matching is often the fastest selector to match for modern browsers. In the case of the example we just had, you could probably use a class like this. It's a box, which would have been the block. There isn't any element, but the modifier would be, say, 3 to show that it's the third box. If you want to know more about BEM, take a look in the instructor notes below. You can choose any number of methodologies for keeping your CSS tidy, so if BEM isn't your thing, there are plenty of others you can try. The key thing is, where you can, keep your selector matching simple.